Another daily cancellation, another viral video that everyone has an opinion about, and most of the opinions are wrong, as usual. And this time, it's a young lady named Brittany Peach, who recently recorded, secretly recorded, and posted a video of herself getting fired from her sales job with a tech company called Cloudflare. Apparently, Brittany, like literally every other employee who's ever been fired from any position ever, disagrees with her termination and feels that she deserves to keep her job. Her employer feels otherwise, and as it usually goes in this sort of situation, her employer's opinion on the matter prevails. After all, when your boss fires you, the decision has already been made. They aren't asking you if you're okay with it or how you feel about it, or they're not taking a poll on the subject. They're not bringing you in and sitting you down and saying, you know, if you're okay, we're going to let you, if you're okay with it, we're going to fire you. It doesn't go that way. They are informing you that you are fired, and that's it. There's almost certainly nothing you can say when you're getting that unfortunate talk. There's almost certainly nothing you can say to change their mind. The decision has already been made. And so the only thing you can do is decide how you'll handle it. Whether you'll handle it, first of all, with some dignity and class, and not start groveling. And also, if you will respond in a way that will increase or decrease your chances of getting another job. This is you know, it's actually, when you're getting fired, this is a big moment in your career. You know, it might be the end of this current job, but it's a pivotal moment in your career, because whether or not you get a better job in the future will hinge in large part on how you respond in this moment, both in the moment and in the moments that come after. Well, unfortunately, Brittany has chosen to respond in a way that's going to hinder her chances of getting another job, because she has decided to respond by secretly recording the meeting and posting it to TikTok for sympathy and clout, which will absolutely ensure that every potential employer in the future will be very wary about hiring her. And most will immediately toss her resume in the garbage 5 seconds after they Google her name, which they will all do. But even though Brittany has decided to implode her career on camera for all to see, she's still being cheered by the vast majority of the peanut gallery. They're very impressed with the video and her performance in it. So before we go any further, we should probably watch some of this video. First, here she is getting the bad news. Listen.
We finished our evaluations of 2023 performance. This is where you have not met Cloudflare expectations for performance. We've decided to part ways with you.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop you right there.
Sure.
So I started August 25th. I've been on a 3-month ramp. And then it was 3 weeks of December, and then a week of Christmas, and then here we are. I have had the highest activity amongst my team. Since I've started, I have had 3 contracts out, done a really great job managing my deals up until the very end that decided not to close last minute. So I don't think that makes a lot of sense for me in my Cloudflare journey here so far. Also, every single one-on-one I've had with my manager, every conversation I've had with him, he has been giving me nothing but, I am doing a great job, I have had great activity, I have really great meetings, I'm picking up the products very quickly, and things have been going really, really well. I make really great relationships with my clients. So I disagree that my performance hasn't been, I haven't met performance expectations when I certainly have, just because I haven't closed anything officially.
Now, we're going to revisit some of that in just a moment. But before we do, we're going to fast forward a few seconds until we get to her employer's explanation, such as it is, for her termination. So here's how they explain it. Listen.
Let me carve out the two threads, the latter of why I'm on this conversation. I'll put that one to the second half, and Rosie might be better to explain the process of who's giving this information in the prior piece, which is your feedback and notes about your performance. So let me add a little color context to that. So just for clarification, you are not being singled out in this. Your peers are also being collectively assessed on performance. This is a collective calibration for Cloudflare. So I just want to clarify that piece. I won't be able to add any kind of specifics on numbers or...
Wait, yeah, no. Can you explain for me why Brittany Peach is getting let go?
I won't be able to go into specifics for numbers.
Wait, why though? I just started. I've been working extremely hard. Just because I haven't closed anything that has nothing to do with my performance on a 3-month ramp with just 1 month with two major holidays in the middle, I don't think that has anything to do with why I should be let go, if that makes sense. So I really need an answer and an explanation as to why Brittany Peach is getting let go, not why Cloudflare decided to hire too many people and are now actually realizing that they can't afford this many people and they're letting that go. If that's the real answer, I would rather just you tell me that instead of making up some bullshit and telling me that right before I lose my job from someone that I've never met before.
Okay, now, as mentioned, this video has been viewed millions of times, and most of the comments have been incredibly supportive of Brittany. It's also been picked up by several media outlets who also paint Brittany as the hero of the story. And for the most part, the Peanut Gallery has agreed that Brittany comported herself very well during this interaction. They say that she was reasonable and well-spoken. They're outraged that Brittany got fired, even though her performance has been great, according to her. They say that she was treated coldly and impersonally, like she was nothing but a faceless cog in the corporate machine. And that's the popular consensus. But again, as is often the case, the popular consensus misses the mark. Mostly misses it anyway. So let's go over a few points. One, yes, it is dehumanizing and demoralizing and depressing, a lot of other D words, to get fired over Zoom by some corporate boss you've never even met. And one who uses phrases like collective calibration. I mean, I got to admit, to hear that at all, but to hear that in the process of getting fired, well, we're doing a collective calibration. That's like soul draining. Like you could feel your soul being drained out of your body when you hear stuff like that. And so if you watch this video and you say to yourself, man, I never want to work for a company like Cloudflare. Well, that makes two of us, right? I'm totally with you. But here's the thing. Brittany did work for a company like Cloudflare. Yes, she's treated like a cog in the corporate machine, but she chose to get a job as a cog in the corporate machine. She was working remotely, apparently, for a tech company with thousands of employees. Like, that's as impersonal as you can get. That's the very definition of being a cog in the corporate machine. Getting fired over Zoom by a company like that, it is dehumanizing, but working over Zoom for a company like that is also, one could argue, dehumanizing. It's understandable if you would rather be dehumanized by a paycheck than by a pink slip, but it does make your complaints about the latter a little bit less credible. Start the new year off knowing that you found the right life insurance to protect your family with Policy Genius. Policy Genius makes it easy to compare life insurance quotes from top companies and find your lowest price. Their licensed agents work for you, not the insurance companies. That means you can trust their guidance because they don't have an incentive to recommend one insurer over another. There are no added fees and your personal information is kept private. A good life insurance plan can give you peace of mind that if something happens to you, your family will be able to cover mortgage payments, college costs, or other expenses. Life insurance through your workplace may not offer enough protection for your family's needs, and it won't follow you if you leave your job. Since life insurance typically gets more expensive as we age, now's the time to buy. Policy Genius makes the process so much easier. With Policy Genius, you can find life insurance policies that start at just $292 per year for $1 million of coverage. Some options offer a same-day approval and avoid unnecessary medical exams. Save time and money and give your family a financial safety net with Policy Genius. Head to policygenius.com/Walsh or click the link in the description to get your free life insurance quotes and see how much you could save. That's policygenius.com/Walsh. People are giving her credit for how she handled herself on the call. Well, personally, I found her to be smarmy and condescending, but that's beside the point. The point is that she shouldn't get credit because she was performing for a camera that the other party didn't know was there. Okay? I don't know why people struggle with this. But like, when someone records themselves doing something, It doesn't make sense to give them credit. Oh, they really handled that well. They're recording themselves. They're doing it for you, to impress you. Okay, like maybe that's how they would respond in a normal situation if the camera wasn't rolling, but we don't know that. You know, it's not a whole lot different from these TikTok videos you see of somebody like giving money to a homeless man or something, doing something nice for a homeless guy. You say, well, this is what humanity is all about. No, it's not. He's doing it for the camera. Okay, it's not. He's only doing it for the camera. He's not. It's not even about the charity at all. Do you really not understand that? So, in this case, she filmed it knowing that she would post it to TikTok afterwards. That means that nothing she says on the call can be taken as honest or genuine. Sure, the corporate drone managers firing her, they weren't being authentic or human, but neither was she. Like, they were following the corporate script, and she was performing for a TikTok audience. The whole thing was an orgy of inauthenticity. And that decision on her part is one that, again, will haunt her for the rest of her professional life. No employer wants to hire someone who might secretly record them and then use the video to smear them on social media. Even if she was the greatest saleswoman in the world, it still would not be worth the trouble. Okay? But as a saleswoman who didn't make a sale in 4 months, it's definitely not even close to worth the trouble. Which brings us to point three. Three, the peanut gallery complains, just as Brittany herself complained, that she wasn't given a reason for her dismissal. Well, that's not entirely true. They said it was performance related. She admits that she hasn't closed a sale since she got the job 4 months ago. She says that that's okay because she manages her meetings well, even though she doesn't convert those meetings into sales. But it's not much of a strain to speculate that her employer doesn't find that reasoning very compelling. Like, they don't give a damn if you're good in meetings, or if you get along with your coworkers, or even if you work hard. They care about results. And if you aren't getting results, you aren't doing your job. And that's most likely why she was fired. Is it harsh? Is it tough? Is it unkind? Sure, probably, I guess. But that's life. And life has not changed much in this regard, okay? In pre-industrial times, the only result that mattered was whether you had a good harvest or whether you had a successful hunt. And if you didn't, you died. And that was that. And now the result that matters at your sales job is whether you make sales. If you don't, you die. Metaphorically, in a professional sense, which is at least preferable to the literal sense, but the principle is the same. Now, could the other people on the call have given her more specific information about why she was fired? Yeah, maybe they could have. But there's a reason why employers are vague in these situations. It's because in many cases, if they tell the truth, if they're totally frank, they'll get sued. Employers try to be as vague and general as possible to avoid liability. So hypothetically, and I don't know anything about this woman. I don't know if this is true. Just hypothetically, if, she's lagging in sales, but maybe there's other people that are lagging in sales too, and they don't get fired, but they chose to fire her because on top of lagging in sales, she's also just obnoxious and unpleasant and nobody wants to work with her. Like, hypothetically, if that was the case, well, that's a valid reason for her to be the one to get fired, but they can't say that. You know, especially in these corporate, they're not going to say, well, you're just an obnoxious, unpleasant person. Nobody wants to be around you, so we're getting rid of you. You're not worth the trouble. Like, you're not worth the trouble. They can't say that because then they'll get sued. And so what happened? Yes, that would be the more human thing. Also more helpful. It's a lot more helpful to tell somebody that so they maybe can have some chance of self-improvement. But, the litigious society we live in means that just honesty goes out the window. Humanity goes out the window. And now, guess what? Now that they have to worry about having the conversation recorded and posted to TikTok, they're going to be even more vague and general. So if you thought that meeting was cold and impersonal, wait until you see how cold and impersonal they will get when the possibility of TikTok infamy is hanging over every meeting of this type. So this hero has just guaranteed that the problem she's exposing will only get a million times worse because of her. Four, finally, it's hard getting fired. It's a hard thing to be fired. I understand that. I've been through it more than once. Humiliation, anger, anxiety, sadness, resentment, like a lot of very difficult emotions are balled up into one messy jumble when you get fired. It sucks. It's, in a word, it sucks to get fired. But here's the part that might come as news to many of our Gen Z friends. Just because you're going through something difficult, just because you're feeling bad about something, just because you're suffering a setback, that doesn't mean that you need to make a national scandal out of it. That doesn't mean you need to broadcast it to the world and make yourself into history's most oppressed victim. You're dealing with something that millions of people have been through. Your version of it may be worse than some, but it's not nearly as bad as most. For instance, if you're single and you have no kids and you get fired, your experience is automatically not that bad compared to the many millions of people who've been fired when they have kids that depend on them, right? Now, that doesn't make your firing any less painful, but it does make it a whole lot less noteworthy, okay? And it does mean that sometimes in life, you just have to take your lumps and move on. You just do. And we can't, like, nobody wants to say that anymore. Like, no one wants to say anymore, yeah, that sucks, that happened. Okay, like, we're all moving on now with our lives, and you need to also. It's just, that's it. Yes, we have acknowledged, oh, but it's hard. Yeah, okay, we all acknowledge that, we get it. But it's really hard. Yeah, okay. We acknowledge it's a really hard thing. But it happened. And that's it. Like, deal with it. Do you want my pity? Okay, well, you have my pity. And take that and $1.50 and it'll get you a Kit Kat at a vending machine. Probably not even that with inflation. So anyway, stop looking for pity. Stop looking for victim points. Get a grip. Collect yourself. Move on with your life. It's your only choice. So you might as well take it. Or else I must say that you, just like our friend Brittany, are today canceled. Hey, YouTube, thanks for listening to the show. If you'd like access to my full show with no ads, you should go to dailywire.com and use promo code Walsh to get 2 months free on all annual plans. See you there.